let's see the structure of amino acids. There is 20 standard type of amino acid, okay, you know, and the two non-standard type of amino acid, that is selenocysteine and pyrrolysine. So let's see the structure one by one. I will tell you and how to remember easily. The simplest structure of aliphatic amino acid is glycine, okay, so in which R group is H. The simplest structure is glycine. Just change the R group. I am explaining how. Just add one methyl group, then it converts into the valine. When you add one methyl group, it converts into the valine. When you add two methyl group extra to this methyl group, that is here. So this amino acid will convert into the alanine. Okay, when one methyl group is added before this carbon atom here, this one, then this alanine is converted into the leucine. And when this methyl group, side chain methyl group, is transferred from this carbon to the isoposition of alpha carbon here, then it is known as isoleucine. So it is very easy, just hydrogen to methyl, methyl to isomethyl, and then one extra isobutyl, then this methyl group is transferred to the isoposition to the alpha carbon. So this is the aliphatic amino acid structure. What are the three amino acids included in the aromatic amino acid? Phenylalanine, tryptophan, and tyrosine. The basic building block is same for all the amino acid: COO minus HNS3 plus. When you add the methyl benzene to R group here, this is a methyl benzene. When you add this group to the R group of amino acid, then this is known as phenylalanine. When you add the phenol group, basically this is the benzene group, when you add the phenol group to this, this converts into the when you add a extra OH or phenol group basically to the this methyl group, then this aromatic amino acid converts into the tyrosine. This is the simple difference between phenylalanine and the tyrosine. And what is the difference between the tryptophan? Tryptophan has the little bit complex structure. How to draw it? The simple CH2 C okay, so this is the side group of tryptophan, one benzene ring. You can see here in all the aromatic amino acids there is a benzene ring. That's why I told you in the absorption lecture that that's because of benzene ring, that's because of presence of benzene ring, they show the absorbance in the presence of radiation. So these are the three aromatic amino acids. What are the hydroxyl containing group amino acids? Serine and threonine. Okay, the basic building block is same for the amino acids. For the serine, here the CH2OH, this is the serine molecule. What is threonine? CH3NOH, this is the threonine. Just one, add one extra methyl group to this carbon, okay, just like for the glycine and valine, or you can say valine and alanine. So here just add one methyl group to this carbon and you will get the structure of threonine instead of serine. So this is the simple structure of alcohol containing amino acids. This is the structure of cysteine, and it convert into the methionine. Just add one methyl group to the this sulfur group, CH2S CH3. This is the R group for the cysteine and this is the R group for the methionine. We are adding just only methyl group to the SS group. in the hydroxyl containing, we are adding the methyl group to this carbon. Okay, so just little bit differences in their structure. If you remember one structure from the any classification of amino acid like hydroxyl containing, aliphatic or the aromatic, then you can draw the second or other structures of amino acid in that classification, in that group. Okay, so let's see the amide amino acids. Okay, amide amino acids like the asparagine and glutamine, they are the modification of aspartic acid and glutamic acid. Okay, what is the structure of aspartic acid? The basic building block is same. What are the differences? And CH2C, this is the aspartic acid. This is the aspartic acid. Basically, when you modify this into the asparagine, when you modify into the asparagine, what is the structure of asparagine? CH2CONH2. This is the amide group. That's why we called as an amide amino acid. For the glutamic acid, what are the structure? The basic building block is same. What is the difference? CH2 add one methyl group in the chain, CH2, then COH. This is the glutamic acid. What are the transformation for the glutamine? Amide group, the building block is same, CH2, and here CONH2, amide group. This is the glutamine, this is glutamic acid, this is asparagine, this is aspartic acid. So these are the modifications of acidic amino acid into the amide amino acids. So let's see the basic amino acids. What are the three basic amino acids? Lysine, arginine and histidine. Okay, so let's draw the structure. I told you already the structure of lysine in the first lecture. For the alpha, beta, gamma, delta and epsilon classification, here building block is same. What are the differences? Draw the four types of methyl group, CH2 methyl chain, CH2 and then amino group. This is the structure of lysine. What are the structure of arginine? Let's draw the structure of arginine. That is CH2, three times CH2, then after NH, C, NH2 plus, NH3 plus. This is the structure of arginine. Here is the difference between the lysine and arginine sequence. Okay, what is the structure of histidine? This group basically known as the guanidino group. Okay, and in histidine there is a imidazole group. We draw the imidazole group. What is that? This is the same. Draw CH2. Okay, so this is the structure of histidine. So this is the imidazole group. And this is guanidino group. So these are the structures of lysine, arginine and histidine. All the amino acids are, you can see, this is the primary amine. They bind to the alpha carbon and they are the basically primary amine. But the proline is the secondary amine in nature. It is a helix breaker. Okay, because it has a cyclic structure, that's why it shows some steric hindrance for the formation of helix. Okay, and the proline is basically derived from the glutamic acid. It is derived from the glutamic acid. Okay, how? The structure of glutamic acid, I told you earlier, C CH2COOH. This is the glutamic acid. After reduction of this glutamic acid, it converts into the this structure. Basically, this carboxylic group converts into the aldehyde group after reduction, and this aldehyde group basically reacts with this amine group and form the structure of proline. Simple. CCOO minus NH CH2. This is the structure of proline. This is 2CH2 and this CH2. H2 is removed through this process and the bond is formed like that. And this amine is basically the secondary amine. Okay, so that's why this is known as the amino acid. So this is all about the structure of all type of standard amino acid. Hope you like my video. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you very much.